you have got to look for the red arrows and the red dots. Every red arrow and every red dot points to the agenda, every agenda point. So if you just follow the red arrows, you have the entire agenda laid out in front of you in this big picture. So a very rapid run through is, we started with the presentation. Charlie said, welcome. I said, I'm so grateful that you have all, the speakers have agreed to come here, and we are in such a nice setting. Pernille took over, also said welcome, and presented this place, Værkstedhuset, as a hotspot for entrepreneurs in Copenhagen. Søren, vugge til vugge, cradle to cradle, had a very long presentation around the cradle to cradle mindset. So why are we doing this? We have a situation where the materials are disappearing. So we've got a guy here looking at a big hole in the ground saying, where's the phosphor? Where's the iron? Where is everything? It's right down there. No, it's disappeared. So we have a new situation. So we have to do something else. We've got to reduce our waste. This guy say, we are very good at saying we have to do less bad, less bad, less bad. No, we have to do good. So the design principles for cradle to cradle is waste equals food. And we got here a banana peel, and there's a fly here saying, well, I knew that, because it is good food. Waste is food. We have to use the solar energy. Local, it's king. So we have to produce local. And the next thing is expect evolution and begin from where we stand. Here's a guy sitting with the toilet paper saying, hey, am I supposed to recycle my toilet paper too? Well, yes. And we've got a shoe here. And this looks like a really old, tired, worn out shoe, but it's actually dreaming of a new life as a fancy furniture. We met a toothbrush as well. And this toothbrush was actually a future bench. So that was one of the things. We went on to three presentations in a row, starting with Kowi, saying this is actually a selling exercise. This is a communication exercise. And it's actually not that difficult to get the management on board, because it's a very good business strategy. So we need to have we have to wear the potential focus glasses on instead of the problem focus glasses. So the key learnings was communication and focus and imagine your positive footprint. Shalala showed us the product here and saying that eco-friendly doesn't have to look but ugly and it can actually be good business. Then we have here as the puppeteer Jasper in stand-in for Hannah, who was sick, and telling about how sustainability and cradle-to-cradle thinking actually is becoming a strategy for the entire region in Midtjylland. Leading on to Scandirock, here we've got Jørgen presenting how stone becomes to paper, and there no hasn't seen a tree, hasn't seen water, and there's no chemistry in it, uses only 50% of the energy, and can be used for all sorts of things, leading into a Q&A, and somebody asked, well, do I have to send this future bench, do I have to send this back to the States, is that sustainable, I wonder? Here we got an ant. This is a super sustainable ant because actually there are more ants mass than there are people body mass on the planet, and it's actually doing good. So we are not overpopulated. Yeah, we are moving on to some more presentations. Marianne told about Better Place and how they provide the infrastructure for the EV business, the electric vehicle. So this is the infrastructure, and it also has to be green energy that we put into it. On to Amma Forbrenning. I don't know if some of you can help me just put it. Perfect, thank you. Amma Forbrenning, well, it might be that we can change a toothbrush into a bench, but if we change all the plastic that we have in the universe, we would have 100 benches per person. So it doesn't do it alone. And here we have a guy who's actually bought a sustainable cradle product, and he's standing here in front of plastic A, plastic B, and plastic C disposal and say, what I'm supposed to do about it. So we have to think about the whole chain. And if we produce something here and it's used here, well, then we cannot make a closed loop. On to Dansk Industri, Danish Industry, and Green Cross. So green business opportunities, and Ulrik told us about that. But it's not a one size fits all, it's not a tool for everything. And we have to look at opportunities and not problems. So here we have a guy here in Denmark saying, well, it's raining outside and we don't have any resources. Well, we might just have a lot of resources, this newcomer says. Fornyelsesfonden Renewable Fund, Cyril, told us about how this fund can help to mature these businesses onto the market and how you can actually apply for money.
Yes.
IKEA goes renewable. It's all about how they are changing their buildings and using the solar energy. And here we have a guy down here saying, oh, it's getting really hot. Well, of course it isn't, because now they consider that. But that is one of the things that IKEA does, apart from have already had it in the history to make products that are very smart for transportation, in weight and so on. This is really rapidly. You can go and have a look afterwards. Leading on to the last bit, a Q&A, different questions, and two presentations from two upcoming businesses here. One with the tool designed for people that had a stroke, and the other one with this ironing board computer dryer thing. And I hope you got really good input for those. And last but not least, Cradle people, please sign up. There are even people in Jutland that are Cradle to Cradle, so that's good news for us. That was what you have heard today. That was a really quick run through of all the inputs. I hope you can have a chance to go here and see it and enjoy it. And if you would like a copy, smaller size, please go to Pernille and sign up, and she will take care of the distribution for that.